Chemotherapy, or simply chemo, is a drug-based cancer therapy. Unlike other breast cancer therapies that specifically target cancer cells or surgically remove the cancer and some adjacent tissue, chemotherapy is unique in that it is a systemic treatment. This means that it works throughout most of the body, making it effective not only for treating a cancerous mass in the breast, but also for cancer cells that may have spread to other parts of the body. New chemotherapy drugs are being developed and studied constantly. This animation will not cover every possible chemotherapy drug and treatment combination, but rather will provide you with an understanding of when and why chemotherapy is used. The delivery process, possible side effects, and other details about what to expect if chemotherapy is part of your breast cancer treatment plan. Like all cancers, breast cancer results from changes called mutations in a cell's genetic material that lead to unregulated cell growth and division. Instead of the normal process where cells grow, divide, and die off when they become old or damaged, cells with certain types of mutations become cancer cells, do not die off, and instead keep multiplying. Uncontrolled growth can form masses known as tumors, and cancer cells from these masses can invade adjoining tissues or spread to other parts of the body through the blood and lymphatic systems. Chemotherapy drugs work by circulating through your bloodstream and inhibiting or preventing cell growth and division. Since cancer cells divide more rapidly than most healthy cells, chemotherapy drugs are able to weaken them and stop them from continuing to grow and spread. The genetic mutations that cause cells to become cancerous also make them less able to repair cellular damage. Chemotherapy takes advantage of this vulnerability, causing cancer cells to die off, whereas healthy cells can often repair themselves and survive. Your medical oncologist will determine if chemotherapy is appropriate based on your type of breast cancer, how aggressive or likely the cancer is to return, your age, menopausal status, other planned breast cancer treatments, your general health, treatment history, and whether the cancer has spread to your lymph nodes. Other considerations may involve specific characteristics of the cancer cells. For example, if they are sensitive to hormones, hormonal therapy may be an additional option. And if the cells produce excessive growth proteins, known as the HER2 status, they may be responsive to treatment with specific drugs. Chemotherapy can be useful for all stages of breast cancer. Chemo may be used for what is called neoadjuvant therapy or adjuvant therapy. Neoadjuvant therapy occurs before surgery and may be used to shrink a tumor to make it easier to eradicate surgically. Adjuvant therapy occurs after recovery from surgery and aims to rid the body of any remaining cancer cells, reducing the chance of the cancer returning, called recurrence. The term adjuvant is used because surgical removal is considered the primary treatment. Sometimes chemotherapy is the only treatment, but more commonly it is used in conjunction with surgery, radiation, or both. For advanced stage breast cancers that have metastasized or spread to other areas of the body, chemotherapy is used to damage or kill as many cancer cells as possible. Additionally, chemo is used to alleviate symptoms associated with advanced stage cancer. There are currently over 100 chemotherapy drugs, with more being developed and studied every year. Some of these types of drugs are used alone, called single-agent chemotherapy, but many are more effective when used in combination, called a chemotherapy regimen. Drug combinations may be able to target different aspects of growth and division, as well as variations among individual cancer cells. Targeting different aspects of cancer cell growth and division also reduces the chance that a new mutation that arises will cause the cancer to become resistant to a particular treatment. Chemotherapy is given as a course of treatment over several months. The course is broken into a number of cycles during which you receive treatment and generally have some time to recover before the next cycle begins. For example, you may receive chemo drugs once a week for 2 weeks, and then have a third week to recover before your next cycle begins. Cycles vary from 2 to 3 weeks to a month or more. Your blood will be drawn often during your treatment for blood cell counts that help assess how well you have recovered and how ready your body is for the next treatment cycle. Some people receive a growth factor that helps their white blood cell counts more rapidly return to normal levels. This strategy is used for what is known as dose-dense chemotherapy, in which cycles are timed closer together. Courses of treatment and cycle lengths vary considerably depending on the type of drugs used, their interactions, and side effects. Breast cancer chemotherapy is commonly administered directly to the bloodstream in liquid form, though some of the drugs may be given orally as tablets or capsules that you swallow. Be sure to take oral medications exactly as prescribed in order to receive the correct dosage and keep your cycle on track. Chemotherapy is usually delivered directly into a vein called intravenous or IV delivery. IV delivery may be done on a visit-by-visit basis using a vein in your forearm or hand, or into a central vein in your chest via a catheter that remains for the duration of treatment. In what is called an IV push, a syringe is used to deliver medication over the course of a few minutes. If your chemo is given by what is called an infusion or slow drip, a bag connected to the catheter delivers medication over a longer time period. The flow rate is often controlled by an IV pump. Primary forms of breast cancer IV chemotherapy delivered via a central venous catheter are known as portocaths, or simply ports, and peripherally inserted central catheters or PICC lines. A port consists of the central line catheter connected to a small chamber that is surgically inserted beneath the skin. A small needle is used to penetrate a membrane atop the chamber to deliver medication. A PICC line runs from a vein in your arm to a large central vein in your chest. The portion that exits the skin is capped or closed, covered with a sterile dressing, and taped to your arm when not in use. In addition to use in a clinical setting, ports and PICC lines are also used with portable electronic IV pumps for continuous infusions that may last several days. Ports and PICC lines allow fluids to be delivered or blood to be drawn as required for chemotherapy treatment without extra needles. Some versions also allow injection of substances that improve certain types of medical imaging. Although chemotherapy works well on rapidly dividing cancer cells, cells in your bone marrow, hair follicles, nails, and the linings of the mouth, nose, intestine, and vagina also divide quickly. When these cells are affected, side effects can result. Possible short-term side effects, which typically disappear after treatment, can include hair loss, mouth sores, irritation on the hands and feet, nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea. Short-term side effects related specifically to bone marrow can include a lowered red blood cell count called anemia and associated fatigue, bleeding or bruising easily due to fewer clot-forming blood platelets, and an increased chance of infection from a lowered white blood cell count. Potential side effects that may disappear after treatment or may persist long-term include numbness, pain, tingling, weakness, or temperature sensitivity in the hands and feet, fatigue or a general feeling of being unwell. Hazy concentration or memory, often referred to as chemo brain, can also occur. Potential long-term side effects include infertility, premature menopause, and an associated loss of bone density or heart damage. Other rare side effects related to specific drugs may also occur. It's important to note that some breast cancer patients have very few side effects, while others have several. And two people with the exact same treatment regimen may experience very different side effects. Your oncologist or cancer nursing team will educate you about side effects related to your particular drugs. Your specific chemotherapy treatment regimen will be carefully monitored in an effort to limit side effects while providing the maximum therapeutic effect. In addition, anti-nausea drugs and adjustments to daily routines while undergoing chemo may be recommended to help manage certain side effects. People undergoing chemotherapy often wonder how they'll know if it is working. Physical exams and imaging tests that assess whether the tumor is shrinking can help determine the success of neoadjuvant therapy. For adjuvant chemotherapy, where the tumor has been removed, effective treatment can only be determined by the lack of cancer recurrence over time. Studies have shown that adjuvant therapy can improve survival rates, which is why it is used. If you receive chemotherapy for cancer that has spread to other areas of the body, blood tests, x-rays, and other scans may be used to monitor your progress. After completing your primary course of chemotherapy, your oncologist will schedule follow-up visits. These visits typically involve a history and physical exam every 4 to 6 months for the first 5 years, then once a year thereafter. You will also be recommended to have yearly mammograms, or additional screenings based on breast density and other characteristics. Depending on the drugs used for treatment and other factors such as menstrual status, other tests may include bone density testing and yearly gynecologic exams may be recommended. New chemotherapy drugs are constantly being studied, and the best treatment regimen is unique for each patient. Chemotherapy works best when tailored to your particular cancer characteristics and you as an individual.